like the historical character that hall brings to the property and how it ties us to it. Look at the trunks, you wouldn't think that because they're smaller, right? The reason
making estate wine here, but then you're also still sourcing fruit, right?
For sure. Yeah.
Where are your favorite places that you're sourcing fruit from around here? It's all within Walla Walla?
No, it's not. So we still are.
This is Columbia Valley.
This is Columbia Valley, right? So, and we will have, we have both Walla Walla wines, ABA designated wines, and we have Columbia Valley designated wines. Mm-hmm. So, we really have evolved. We're leading with Cabernet. So Cabernet, we feel like, is really, again, to that point of like the Merlot, is that all the Bordeaux's here do very well, and they all strike that balance, I think, between Old World and New World, which we really love. And then you have this, Syrah thing happening here that's also just super exciting.
Yeah.
And so we lead with, I'd say, Cabernet and the Bordeaux blends, and then Syrah. Is something that we have really been developing, and we've got a Syrah that sells out every year that's kind of a fan favorite, and so we're looking to grow that program. More on that in the future. But so in Walla Walla, the vineyards that we source from are Seven Hills and Lake Helene. And so those we source from here, for this harvest for 2019, those are the two Walla Walla vineyards.
And then Valley Grove Vineyard.
And of course our estate. Right. And then outside of Walla Walla, I work with a vineyard called Discovery, which is in Horseheaven Hills. It's owned by just a fantastic family that bought a piece of property that I don't think they realized at the time necessarily what they had, but they had this amazing vineyard site that sits up above the Columbia River, literally on the bluff above the river looking into Oregon. And it's just this gorgeous site with the wind coming up off the river all day long. And it's just really stunning and pretty. And I love the fruit that comes out of there. And then the western part of the Columbia Valley and the Yakima Valley area has some of the oldest vines in the state. And so we've been fortunate to get into some vineyards there that we've developed a relationship with over the years and will continue to source from, just because I love what's coming out of there.
Excellent.
It's a really neat area because it's all pretty close, or within maybe a couple hours to my furthest site. But it's really amazingly different terroirs. Amazingly different terroirs within the Columbia Valley. And so it's fun to be able to explore those, which is why I like sourcing from other vineyards as well.
Yeah. Do you still have your tasting room in Woodinville?
We do.
In addition to the one?
Yeah. What had been our original production winery is still there and has our tasting room, and as a matter of fact still has tanks and equipment because we haven't been able to build a facility here yet to move it into.
Right. So are you still making wine there?
We're not. We're making it out here
We're
in Custom Crush for a couple of years until we get the building set.
Well, there you go. But it's nice. You have some equipment to get started with once
it's
built.
We have all the equipment.
There you go.
Yeah, we're very anxious to get our building
built. I can imagine.